So here's a question. Is the vaccine mentioned or even alluded to slightly in the Nicene Creed? Well, let's ask a few questions and figure this out. In the year 325, hundreds of bishops gathered in the city of Nicaea, and the result was the first articulated creed of the Orthodox Christian faith called the Nicene Creed. And they put down in that the central tenets of what we have believed ever since. They started off by mentioning that we believe in one God, the Father, who creates the heavens and the earth. They continue on into some fairly deep and concise Christology. That's the main body of the work of the Nicene Creed, articulating that Jesus is fully human and fully divine. He is God in the flesh, and he has the same essence as God, and they use some interesting and technical language to make sure we get the point that Jesus is really God and he is really human. And then it proceeds to a statement about the Holy Spirit, who proceeds from the Father, and later versions would say from the Father and the Son, and that we believe in one unified apostolic church. So, where's the vaccine? Whereabouts in those texts is the vaccine? And the answer would be nowhere. Absolutely nowhere. So why am I even bringing this up? Why am I asking the question? Well, the reason I'm bringing it up is because some of us need reminding that the vaccine is not an issue of Christian orthodoxy. I'll say that again. The vaccine is not an issue of Christian orthodoxy. Now, for some people, it has become that. For some people who are adamantly anti-vaccine, they would look at people who have gotten the vaccine and say, "You've bowed the knee to Caesar. You've denied your faith. You're looking at medicine and science as being the savior, whereas Jesus is the savior." And so there's this sense in which some have crossed the line of apostasy. Some people on the other side who are passionately pro-vaccine would say, well, the people who are not getting the vaccine are denying the first and central tenet of the Christian faith, which is love the Lord your God and love your neighbor as yourself. And this is an opportunity for us to love our neighbor in a deferential and thoughtful way. And if you're not doing that, then you've denied something very core to the Christian faith. And so there are these two very polar opinions that are echoing off each other, and the noise is increasing to become almost deafening at this point. So, what's to be done? Well, I would say that even in light of passions being incredibly high on both sides of this issue, it is not a good enough reason to break Christian faith with brothers and sisters. It might be good enough reason to have some hearty discussions, but it's not a good enough reason to break faith, and that is what is happening in some corners of the church. People are judging brothers and sisters as if the vaccine is an issue of Christian orthodoxy. Now, I know the stakes are incredibly high. We're in a full-blown health crisis. Some are blaming the government. Some are blaming those who haven't been vaccinated. Some are blaming dark and nefarious powers behind the scenes that are manipulating the situation to try and take over the world. There's all kinds of theories and ideas as to what's going on. But none of them are as important as the statements that we find in the Nicene Creed. That's the truth that comes straight out of the Bible and is articulated for us in some beautiful ancient text. That's the truth that holds us together. It's more important than an opinion. It's more important that the church take this opportunity to demonstrate leadership, to demonstrate to the community what it's like when we very strongly disagree with each other, but we can still remain in faith. We can still remain in fellowship. So, the church has got all kinds of opportunities at this moment in history to demonstrate civic leadership, social responsibility, loving care to neighbour, etc. But it also has a very good opportunity, a very difficult opportunity, to demonstrate to our community what does it look like to disagree strongly with somebody and yet still love them. Because that's the call that Jesus puts out, isn't it? He calls his people to this love of another kind. That is something that when the community sees it, it doesn't really understand it, but it's magnetized towards it. There's something powerful and beautiful about the church really being the church, even in the midst of disagreement. So I know that this is not easy, and some might think I'm naive for even putting this on the table, but I think it's important to remind ourselves the vaccine is not an issue of Christian orthodoxy. It's incredibly important at this point for healthcare reasons, but the statements that we find in the Nicene Creed that articulate for us the central tenets of the beauty and the plenitude and the wonder of our God and the faith that we may have in Him, that is more important than any opinion. It's more important than any political party. It's more important than any social agenda. It is the central core of the truth of the gospel that holds us together even in a storm like this. So, this is some food for thought. I'd love to hear from you, and we'll see you again soon. Take care. Peace.